Okay. So, back to what I was saying, part two. So, mincing the regular food, which was the ground beef with the seitan beef, it really affected me in so many ways, and it affected me for 3 days straight. Like I said, I wasn't feeling good, and I was in the bathroom a lot. So, how to listen to your body and what to do, you know, when it comes to the responses, you get the results. So, once you start listening to your body, the results is amazing. Like, you're going to see dramatic results within a month. So, let me give myself another example. Like I say, I'm going to let y'all know how I did it and why it worked for me. To each his own. You could do it if you want. You could try it out. It's whatever. But, so, I listened to my body. Take, for example, pork. Everybody hates pork. Everybody don't like the way pork affects them, but somehow some people still consume it. I used to consume a lot of it, and I was eating from penne to pork ribs. It was crazy, and I didn't want to stop. I was eating it for years, and I'm talking about over 15, 16 years. What really made me stop for good now, because I was sitting here still eating it even to this year, was when I bought the pernil. I cooked it very well. So don't come for me in the comments about I don't know how to cook. That's why it hurt in my stomach. No. My body was telling me something that I didn't want to listen to. And when you don't listen to your body, it backfires on you 10 times. So every time I would take a bite of the pork, my stomach would get upset so fast. Within 5 minutes after eating pork, I would start feeling sick. I was almost like to the point I wanted to throw up. Sorry if I ruined your breakfast or anything like that, but that was just the truth. I was eating pork constantly, and I kept eating it. And I didn't notice the reason why I was feeling sick right after is because of the pork. It wasn't because I was eating. It was because of the pork. And then I was like, hold up. I ate pork in December. I was like, what's going on? I was telling the doctor every time I eat, I feel sick right after. Didn't know why. So she said, what is it that you're eating? I was like, everything. I was eating normal food. I couldn't pinpoint anything because I didn't remember. Yo, I couldn't remember. When it comes to things like this, my memory is shot. I don't know why. I'm young. I should be remembering everything. But the fact that I didn't remember that I was eating pork at that time, and that's the reason why I was feeling sick a lot, or any food that has pork in it, it was like, it wasn't done. My body wasn't dealing with it very well. So I did it one more time in January. I had a slice of pork. And about 10 minutes after, I went to go sit down in my bed to watch a movie on my phone. And my stomach started hurting again. And it was hurting all day. I couldn't eat lunch. I mean, I couldn't eat dinner. I couldn't eat nothing. For the next day, still couldn't eat nothing. I was drinking a whole lot of coffee, a whole lot of tea, hoping that the tea and stuff, the heat would like bring it down a little bit. And I was taking stool softeners. I was doing a lot. Like, trust me, it was embarrassing. It was hurtful. My stomach was cramping up for hours. So it was like, okay, Sherelle, why aren't you listening to your body? Hello, red flag. Your body is telling you stop eating pork. Your body is not used to pork. So I'm like, oh, now here it comes. I have to stop eating what I love the most. That means don't even go to the restaurants to even get pork. Don't even try to cook pork anymore. Okay. So I substitute that for more fish. And I wasn't a big fish eater, but now I love fish. And I could consume that all day, every day if I want and not get sick and tired of it. So what did I do? I spent $50 on fish. Yes, I did. And I don't regret it. Like, honestly, I'd rather spend more money on fish than I do on beef or any type of meat. But that was a regret, a huge regret that I made in January buying so much pork because it cost me $35. That was $35 down the drain because I couldn't even eat all that pork. I got it from the butcher's market and I wasted that $35. So, yeah, That's the biggest regret I have. And to answer some people's questions out there, the biggest regret when it comes to spending your money on buying pork. Oh yeah, it wasn't buying sweets or anything. It wasn't buying alcohol. It was buying pork. So another thing that would tell you if your body should get rid of it or not is like, how you say it? I ain't word that right. Another way to listen to your body. Okay, here's the thing. I dreamt and prayed on certain foods, right? So I was like, that's my way of asking God what I should get rid of and what I shouldn't get rid of. So I thought I had to get rid of chicken. I was like, what about chicken? No, chicken ain't doing shit. It doesn't affect you. It doesn't affect you in a bad way, nor does it affect you in a good way. It's just chicken. Chicken is chicken, just like fish. You do get a lot of benefits off of eating it, but it's the way you cook it. But how I listen, like I say, I was listening to my body through trying out different things. You try what works for you. If you drink something and you know it's not good for you, your body's telling you it's not good for you, stop drinking it. Like, I quit alcohol. It gained so much sugar, like, oh my God. Yo, the sugar and the weight gain off it was ridiculous. 15 pounds. So I broke down everything I was eating and drinking, and I found my answer as to why I have reached up to 233 pounds. So 50% was on fatty foods, 20% was on alcohol, and if I'm not mistaken, like 5 to 10% was like on, maybe like 30% was on alcohol, sweets, and sugar and all that stuff. So I broke it down. I made a chart. I also did a vision board, and I was listening to what my doctor was telling me to do. So what I was doing was doing a vision board on what I was eating and drinking and stuff, and what I wanted to take out and what I wanted to add on to it. So I was like, I wish I could eat this healthy stuff. I wish I could, you know, prioritize everything that was in my life. So how to get rid of this and how to add on to this, and then how to eat smaller meals. I wish I could eat smaller meals so I could like lose as much weight as I want, gain muscle, and look amazing and feel amazing. And losing water weight was the hardest, and then losing the fat was even harder. And like I said, I did the vision board. I went on my pad, my little tablet, as you can see here, and I started writing down the stuff that I liked and love. And they was like, okay, what do you love that doesn't love you right back? I was like, ah, fast foods. So what did I do? Got rid of it. I was like, how can I eat what I love in a healthier way? So all this food that you was eating and consuming from the bodegas, from the delis, from supermarkets and stuff like that, like that wasn't even good, because you know in the supermarket section they got cooked food in the deli area. I got rid of that too. And then also restaurants, I got rid of that. I started cooking everything on my own. And long story short, I made everything that I love from these fast food restaurants, and I made it in my own kitchen from scratch in a healthier way. And me eating like that, it also made me lose 5 pounds every month. And they was like, slow and steady wins the race. They was like, the quicker you lose the weight, the quicker it comes back on you. Being that I'm a diabetic and the way I was active, it was taking a longer time for me to lose the weight. So altogether, within 2 months, I lost 10 to 15 pounds. Yes, that's not great for somebody that's like me, but I have insulin resistance, so I had no choice. So that's what stopped me. And then another thing that I had to lose out on was drinking. Like, my favorite drinks was vodka. It was wine. It was martinis. Anything vodka-based. I was drinking it constantly, almost every weekend. If I had the money, I would spend it. Like, I made one stupid mistake listening to Paris Hilton. Food or vodka? She chose vodka. So I was like, let me start that. So I bought a big-ass bottle of vodka for $20-something, and I didn't eat for that night. I went throughout the whole weekend with no food and I was starving. So I ended up losing weight from that. Then I was like, I'll never make that mistake again, but it was the funniest thing ever. I was like, but I learned my lesson from that, surely. So about 2 months after, I was making another vision board. What do I want in my life? And how can I get rid of the bad things out of my life? Praying, manifesting, and doing affirmations 3 times a day was what brought so much shit in my life that I have now that I love. I was like, I wanted peace to my life. I wanted love. I wanted a career, a home, a family, and I wanted real love in my life, like a relationship. And I was like, I would do everything I can to work on that and to keep my mind off for it. I mean, keep my mind off the bad stuff and keep my mind on the good stuff. So keep thinking about it and manifesting it. It will come. That alone also caused me to lose the headaches. I wasn't gaining much, you know, of anything anymore. Like the weight, the headache, the aggravation, it all went away once I started thinking about myself. Once I started, you know, praying and meditating and everything. That's also, but back to what I was saying about the portion control. Yeah, I ate dessert plate meals. I didn't eat big plate meals. I ate small plate meals. And I wasn't eating all day, every day. I was doing intermittent fasting. So I had an 8-hour window. Some people do it from 11 to 7. Others do 12 to 8. I did 11 to 7. And it still works for me to this day. And my body got so used to it to the point. Now I don't even have to keep track of time. It automatically does what it does. Like my body, I could sit here and try to prepare a meal 2 hours before 11 o'clock. And my body won't be hungry until 11 o'clock strikes. And it's like, how you even get to do that, I don't even know. I tell my body, you're amazing, because I don't even have to keep looking at the time to see what time it is for me to eat. My body already knows. So that's what I was doing. And I was eating every 4 hours. So it was 11, 3, 7. Every day after that, I won't eat. If you still feel hungry after 7 o'clock, the only thing you could eat is the, you know, your little snacks. You could take your snacks like fruits. You could have your little granolas. But that is it. Nothing else. Don't sneak in nothing else, because this is what messes you up at night. And this is what messes you up, period. When you feel like you can't sleep well, it's because of what you're eating and how late you're eating. And that goes for everybody. That's a universal sign. No, that's a universal turn of like, don't ever do that. So look out for part 3. For this, and I'll tell you how I end up going from 233 down to 180.